Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to do the first chapter of history, that is a period of transition. Let us begin. History is the study of changing patterns in the society. To characterize these changes, historians have divided history into three periods: ancient, medieval, and modern. These broad divisions mark how society, economy, culture, and politics of one period differed from the preceding and succeeding periods. It must be remembered that the change from medieval to modern did not happen overnight. It took a long period of time. It was a gradual process and took place over a period of time. Also, the modern period did not begin at the same time in all the parts of the world. So, here we come to know that different changes took different sort of time. The 18th century is generally taken as the starting point of the modern period in India. This was the time when the British became the masters of India. They brought about many changes in different fields of life. The changes were so radical that they are said to have constituted a new period. On the other hand, the modern period in Europe began from the 16th century. That means the modern period began in the 16th century for Europe and for India in the 18th century. Sources. Let us know about the sources. There is an abundance of source materials for the modern period in India. These can be divided into two groups: primary sources and secondary sources. Primary sources. These include original documents such as letters, government reports, autobiographies, newsreels, newspapers, speeches, audio recordings, video recordings, photographs, sculptures and paintings, and archaeological remains such as monuments and artifacts. These have been preserved in archives and museums. Secondary sources. Historians study primary sources and interpret them. These interpretations constitute secondary sources. These are available to us as reports, reviews, articles, and books by historians. Let us know about modern Europe. The modern period is characterized by greater interaction among the countries of the world. India was influenced by the developments in other parts of the world. Therefore, before we study the history of modern India, it is important to know about the significant events and changes that took place in the other parts of the world during this time. Renaissance. The word Renaissance literally means rebirth, means to take birth once again. That takes place once again, newly, in a new time. It was a cultural movement that spanned roughly the 14th century and 17th century. The movement began in Italy and spread to the rest of Europe. Renaissance aimed to revive classical glory, allowed seeds to be planted easily deep into the earth, and a horse-drawn machine which loosened the soil and killed weeds, improved agriculture productivity. Better coal mining techniques developed. In the course of time, all major industries were affected by the Industrial Revolution. The Industrial Revolution gradually spread across Europe and to the United States, Japan, and many other countries of the world. Now, what was the impact? The impact was the Industrial Revolution led to sweeping changes in Europe and elsewhere. Rise of capitalism. Industrialization led to the decline of feudalism in Europe. A new system arose in its place. It was a system in which means of production were privately owned and operated for profit. It was called capitalism. New social classes. Capitalism gave birth to two new social classes. One was that of the factory owners who employed workers and paid them wages. The main aim of the factory owners was to make profits. They controlled the capital or money and hence were called the capitalists. They were very prosperous and led a life of luxury. The other class was the workers who worked in the factories and received wages for their labor. They were an exploited lot and lived in a great hardship. Emergence of towns and cities. The new machines were too big to fit into people's homes. So, factories were built where capitalists installed the machines as they liked. With the abolition of serfdom in the 18th century, a large number of people became free. They moved to the cities looking for work. Thus, cheap labor was easily available. The British government, with its strong navy, embarked on a policy of geographical expansion. This led to rapid colonization, which enabled England to get cheap raw materials from the countries it colonized. These colonies also served as markets where the British could dump their finished products for sale. An atmosphere of scientific inquiry and an improved transport system in the form of canals and roads helped England become the first industrialized nation. Major inventions during that time. The textile industry was the first to be mechanized. James Hargreaves' spinning jenny, Richard Arkwright's water frame, Samuel Crompton's spinning mule, Edmund Cartwright's power loom, John Kay's flying shuttle, and many other inventions increased the production of cloth. Lancashire and Yorkshire emerged as the two main centers of the textile industry. The improved steam engine by James Watt replaced water and horsepower in many industries. George Stephenson's steam-powered locomotive helped in the transport of raw materials from one place to another. Inventions such as the seed drill, that is, a mechanical seeder that allowed seeds to be planted, the overland route was no longer available for trade. The Turks blocked the trade routes of Asia. A new route to Asia thus had to be discovered, and this led to a race among European countries to find a new sea routes. Many European rulers financed expeditions to discover new trade routes to the east. The tremendous growth in geographical knowledge and the invention of new scientific instrument gave a fillip to explorations. Improved maps and instruments such as the quadrant and astrolabe, the mariner's compass and adjustable sails made sailing at sea safer. The invention of the gun and gunpowder helped safeguard ships from attacks by sea pirates. Thus, new sea routes and new lands were discovered by sailors and explorers. In 1488, Bartolomeo Diaz reached the southernmost tip of Africa and named it the Cape of Good Hope. Vasco da Gama followed the same route and reached India in 1498. Christopher Columbus also set out to discover a sea route to Asia but discovered the Americas instead. Later, Amerigo Vespucci also reached the Americas. Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese sailor, was the first to sail around the world. The Industrial Revolution. An ever-increasing volume of trade meant that more goods had to be produced in a shorter time to meet the demands of the market. The domestic system of production, under which the artisan collected raw materials from the merchant, made goods at the home using his or her bare hands, or at best some simple tools, and then supplied the finished goods to the merchant, could not meet the growing demands of the market. A strong need was therefore felt for a new system of production. The factory system of production developed in the 18th century. So the factory system of production, developed in which century? It was the 18th century. Rich merchants set up factories, installed newly invented machines, bought raw materials from the market, and employed workers on wages to produce goods on machines. This development is known as the Industrial Revolution. It is called a revolution because it marked a radical change from the domestic system of production. Why England? The Industrial Revolution began in England in the middle of the 18th century. England at this time was in an advantageous position to start and sustain an Industrial Revolution. England had an abundant supply of natural resources, especially coal and iron, needed for industrialization. It had a stable government which encouraged trade and commerce. Thus, the British traders and merchants were given the liberty to trade as they liked. With the abolition of serfdom in the 18th century, a large number of people became free. They moved to the cities looking for work. Thus, cheap labor was easily available. The British government, with its strong navy, embarked on a policy of geographical expansion. This led to rapid colonization, which enabled England to get cheap raw materials from the countries it colonized. These colonies also served as markets where the British could dump their finished products for sale. An atmosphere of scientific inquiry and an improved transport system in the form of canals and roads helped England become the first industrialized nation. Major inventions during that time. The textile industry was the first to be mechanized. James Hargreaves spinning jenny, Richard Arkwright's water frame, Samuel Crompton's spinning mule, Edmund Cartwright's power loom, John Kay's flying shuttle, and many other inventions increased the production of cloth. Lancashire and Yorkshire emerged as the two main centers of the textile industry. The improved steam engine by James Watt and horsepower in many industries. George Stephenson's steam-powered locomotive helped in the transport of raw materials from one place to another. Inventions such as the seed drill, that is, a mechanical seeder that allowed seeds to be planted easily deep into the earth, and horse hoe, a horse-drawn machine which loosened the soil and killed weeds, improved agriculture productivity. Better coal mining techniques developed. In the course of time, all major industries were affected by the Industrial Revolution. The Industrial Revolution gradually spread across Europe and to the United States, Japan, and many other countries of the world. Now, what was the impact? The impact was the Industrial Revolution led to sweeping changes in Europe and elsewhere. Rise of capitalism. Industrialization led to the decline of feudalism in Europe. A new system arose in its place. It was a system in which means of production were privately owned and operated for profit. It was called capitalism. New social classes. Capitalism gave birth to two new social classes. One was that of the factory owners who employed workers and paid them wages. The main aim of the factory owners was to make profits. They controlled the capital or money and hence were called the capitalists. They were very prosperous and led a life of luxury. The other class was the workers who worked in the factories and received wages for their labor. They were an exploited lot and lived in a great hardship. Emergence of towns and cities. The new machines were too big to fit into people's homes. So, factories were built where capitalists installed the machines. People working at home could not compete with the factory-made goods. So, they had to go and work in the factories. Thus, with industrialization, the center of economic life shifted from villages to cities. Many industrial towns and cities, such as Manchester and Liverpool, emerged. People migrated from villages to these cities in search of jobs in factories. Growth of imperialism. With the growth of the factories, the industrialized countries of Europe were faced with two crucial concerns. One was the need for cheap raw materials to manufacture goods, and the other was to find markets for the finished goods. Political domination of the less developed countries solved these two problems. The establishments of colonies in Asia, Africa, and Americas by European countries helped to sustain the industrial revolution. Imperialism. Imperialism is the policy of extending political and economic control over a weak country by a powerful one. This phenomenon gained strength in the 19th century, largely due to the Industrial Revolution. The Industrial Revolution, which led to a tremendous increase in the production of goods. The European countries needed markets for the manufactured goods, new sources of cheap raw materials to manufacture more goods, and areas in which they could invest their surplus capital. This led them to acquire colonies in Asia and Africa, continents rich in natural resources but militarily weak. The race to acquire colonies peaked during the latter half of the 19th century. By the beginning of the 20th century, almost the whole of the non-industrialized world had come under the control of a few industrialized countries. Britain, France, Belgium, and Spain were the main colonial powers. Now, impact. The colonialists exploited the colonies economically. The local industries of the colonized countries were practically destroyed. For example, the influx of cheap machine-made goods destroyed the indigenous textile industries of India. The colonies were treated as mere suppliers of raw materials. No efforts was made to industrialize the colonies. In Burma, now Myanmar, the British exploited her natural resources and granted themselves the exclusive right to sell the manufactured products that Burma needed. Agriculture, too, was modified.